We just let
okay, we're back. We're with you. We're again right in your face, and we're talking about more on federalism. On this topic, let's go forward. We have Citizen Bono, you have Bono Adasa, and we have Ding Generoso. Gentlemen, let's talk about con ass vis-a-vis con. Which way to go? You promote con. And yet the president, last he spoke about this system, it's con ass. Bono, Citizen
you
Bono.
Know, from the philosophical fundamental point of view, if it's a choice between the two, I'll really choose all the time a constitutional convention, because the philosophy behind forging a constitution, is it should be a result of universal thinking among the people. Con us, the words itself is reprehensible. Con and us.
A but negative donkey.
You know, an ass. You know what an ass is?
You mean the donkey?
An ass is an
again,
animal.
Again, we're talking about the Philippines. Let's not talk about America.
An ass is an animal who doesn't know whether he's a donkey or a horse. In other words, it's confused identity, right?
Yeah.
Now, when you turn Congress into a constituent assembly, that's what you will have, confused identity. The congressmen and senators will not know whether they are writing a law, investigating, or writing a constitution.
Oh, there you go.
So we might as well have a con-con, so that you have some minds like the mind of Bono Adasa here.
You know,
we need fresh minds for, fresh minds for con-con.
But the arguments are cost of a con-con, again, the general elections, and three, the political dynasties, who already reign in Congress today.
That's why
you cannot have a Congress do it, because you have all the political dynasties there. When you have a con-con, there is a chance that you will have probably just 10% political dynasty and 90% non-dynasty.
I interject a new component, based on precedents. Because, we've always been dealing in this country with formal democracy. We always think at the back of our minds is institutions based on formal democracy, because we really never have democracy here. The essence of democracy, it does not exist. Formal democracy, yes.
Our concept of democracy is just election.
Yeah, correct. and election is a perverse approach.
It's the perversion of democracy.
Oh, it's a perversion.
Well, we're not talking about smartmatic.
No.
We're already done with that.
No, let me interject this idea. No. If you really want to think outside of the box and interject a new component in the thinking of Filipinos, this is my proposal or recommendation. It does not have to be accepted, but it is based on certain precedents. Mm-hmm. You know, when the 13 states of the United States of America broke away from Britain, the basic instrument, the fundamental law, was written only by one person.
Thomas Jefferson.
Thomas Jefferson, whom even the late President Kennedy acclaimed as much better than the combination of all geniuses. And I agree. We are 106 million, maybe at that particular time there were only 20 million Americans, probably. But now we are 106. I don't like to be insulted that no one can do the work of a Jefferson in our present context. Cheaper, hardly with any cost.
It was promoted to the president and proposed that there be a 25-man board that will form this committee that will propose to the president and to Congress before it is submitted for a plebiscite.
Yes.
So do we go for a con-con, which is a regional representation? How about the party list? Another problem. So what would be the number of a con-con or the assemblymen? Two, what would be the 25 people or vis-a-vis that or versus that versus one, which is better?
Well the consultative body or the group of experts is supposed to make the first draft.
The
Constitution, yes, the 25, to make it easier for whichever it is, con-con or con-as, to do their job.
No,
so at least they have a starting document. They will not start from zero. That will speed up the process.
You disagree
instead
with
of
that,
2 years, you can probably do it in a year.
I disagree with both, the process. My procedure will be this. The president gets some Filipinos from somewhere. This country has been a brilliant mind. Maybe as brilliant as Thomas Jefferson.
Yeah.
I refuse to say that. Before, you know, when we were only 65 million, some people keep on telling me, there's only one Marcos. What are you talking about? Mm-hmm. There must be one in every million. The only difference between Marcos and the 64 others is Marcos has responded.
But there
the
is only one
them.
Bono Adas.
Ah, no. Let's get that out of the picture because they might think that my recommendation.
Gentlemen, you're supposed to debate, not agree with each other.
No, but debate on matters where we disagree. Yeah. But then is a very rational component, and so am I.
Yes, sir.
If you have an irrational component, we will be disagreeing from beginning
but
to end.
But the identification of a good, intelligent person versus the perception of a good, intelligent person, the reality suffers.
No.
Because once they get into power and influence, people change.
No. This is my proposal. The president names that person. No. All right, write the constitution in 15 days. A person with authority and the necessary brains can do the proposal and they submit it to the president.
Too simple?
And the president can maybe get five people or
it
experts.
It can be done.
Yeah.
Really. If we want to shortcut the process, but perhaps the president doesn't want just one, no? So he gets 25.
Mm-mm. Too many.
Maybe too many.
Tell
the
president maybe five.
Five may be okay.
Maybe we can.
Five may be
we
okay.
Can compromise on five, but 25.
But 25, to yeah. To really start, because it would be far easier to get agreements among 25 different brains
versus five.
So if we're looking at coming up with a draft within so many days, I guess five would be a reasonable number.
In Paris time, we had 55, where five were against the 50. When they came up with the 1987 revolutionary constitution.
That was already a commission.
The commission was 55-man board, yes. Wherein five actually went against the other 50. So five, the magic number is five. How do we identify an intellectual, one that comes from the academe and one who's an experienced seasoned politician? Who is the better person of the two?
Well, none could be better.
I don't like to render a judgment because my judgment will be considered biased. Will be considered definitely biased.
Well, let's say one is always better in his field than the other. So the politician will always be a better politician than one
but
from the
But if we
academy.
Only had to okay. choose one, who should we go for? Like the Constitution. If we were to make changes, we would like some expertise, especially coming from the academe, and yet the experience of a politician where he understands the nature of perception, power, influence, and office, and the people being a representative of the people, who has better experience from the two?
But Harry, all these qualifications that you're thinking about can be merged into one single person.
But we already lost Marcos. He died some time
no,
ago.
No, but there are 104 others. You have 105 million before the
one in every
64
million.
Others. One in every million. That's a rational assessment. Look,
let me
the guy who has held a public position, maybe for
one.
Some time, that's one. No. One who has been teaching constitutional law. Or comes from the academy,
yes.
From...
That's a nice...
Or a retired...
Very nice.
Justice.
One who was held...
Wait, let's not talk about the justice system. No. The judiciary is one of we intend to eliminate and cut its head off.
No, that's one... That's another subject. That's for some other time.
Totally.
We can have another edition on that, reforming the judiciary.
Number two is a person who has also held public office, but not elected, and who was in... implemented the constitution in various capacities. It's not difficult to find. I'm sure it's not difficult to find.
So
we can
do
I don't like to recommend now because you might be looking at two of them.
Let me ask this question because Ding has been part of the task force that has been mandated or appointed for the purpose of explaining and talking to the people in general. You've been going around the country
yes.
talking. I've seen a lot of your photos, videos. You're going around north to south.
Yes.
And the rigorous campaign is not for self-interest or gain, but to basically get a feel of the people. Where has this taken you? And how has this come back to you?
Well, we've talked to a lot of people, local officials, students, labor, different sectors.
Farmers even, I've
yes,
noticed.
Farmers even, yes. I think that the moment that they understand what the Constitution is and what federal unitary system is, they tend to agree that there is a need to change the Constitution and to change the system. You see, the difficulty in propagating the idea of federalism to our people is that it is a bit abstract. So what we've done is we've tried to sort of
simplify
and relate it to the stomach. So when we do presentations, we start off with something like, what are the realities in Philippine society? We're a rich country, yet
gutom tayo.
11 million Filipinos have AIDS. Yeah, it's called acute income deficiency syndrome.
Oh, okay.
It's 11 million.
Nagulat ako kasi alam mo, 4,600 lang, but go ahead. Correct.
So, things like this. And then we relate, bakit ba mahirap ang bansa? Kasi yung sistema natin, unequal ang development because the very system of government perpetrates an unequal distribution of wealth. So, pag naintindihan ng tao, kasi mayroong mga magtatanong sa iyo minsan na magsasakay, eh, bababa ang presyo ng abono pag nag-federal system tayo. I
mean, ang bababa, ang bono lang. Hindi ang abono.
si Bono talagang matagal
lang. Pro bono.
Mababa presyo nito.
How does the Filipino understand the Constitution with all its current complexities? Number one, it's too tedious to read and too long.
Yes. And very difficult to understand the language that they use.
And everything is always until further approved by Congress.
Until further notice.
Until further notice. So what do we do first? Shouldn't we change the Constitution as a whole?
Let me share with you my experience, and I want to share it with the, you know, as governor of Misamis Oriental under very difficult conditions because I was an opposition governor. Whenever I moved around in Misamis Oriental, I always had the opportunity of explaining to him the better system for the country, the federal and parliamentary system. And he's correct, Ding is correct. Whenever you talk to the people and explain in very simple terms the concepts, everybody agrees. My experience.
Mayors, at the start, I had a talk.
But surely the complexity of moving, changing a system from a unitary presidential system to a parliamentary federal system cannot be that simple, because even as we discuss, we debate, there are so many issues and sensitive points of views that need to be discussed.
Yes, but the impact can be simplified. Like for instance, we asked, last Friday I had several mayors for audience. I asked them, dun ba sa bayan nyo, yung inyong police chief, eh may kapangyarihan na bumili ng patrol car? And they said no. Hindi. Why not?
Why? Central because government, yes.
Centralized, pagbili lang natin ng bala at baril ng PNP, kailangan centralized, sa karami lang pinag-uusapan. So bago dumating yung bala sa tawi-tawi, yung huhulihin na magnanakaw, nandun na sa, nasa Sabah na.
Correct.
Nasa Malaysia na. So,
good point.
You explain it that way, then they understand. Ngayon, pag nagka-disaster, sinong bumibili ng relief goods? DSWD, saan? Dito sa Maynila. Saan iimpake? Meron silang warehouse dyan sa Paranaque. Tapos, nasira na yung tulay, saka ka maghahanap ng dadaanan ng truck para dalhin mo yung relief goods sa probinsya. No. That's how the centralized system operates. Yeah. Now, you decentralize, you federalize, bring down everything. Bahala na yung governor, mayor, mamili ng relief goods.
Centralization really is a major problem. Because first, based on what we hear about the experience of our people in many disasters, including Yolanda, aid funneled through the national government, very good canned foods.
Yeah.
When they reach the area, it's no longer the same canned foods that were donated here, because the canned foods donated here ends up in the store already in Metro Manila. Problem number
one. Grocery na.
I thought it was just the brand LP, hindi pala, no? But go ahead.
Another thing, so much money has been donated by various governments all over the world, especially the European Economic Community, but funneled through Manila. People are wondering, where is the money? They're still wondering until now.
I'm still wondering.
And some people are saying that, the money that was donated in Yolanda is now in the bank in Sydney, Australia, brought there by a member of the cabinet or two members of the cabinet. I don't know whether it's true, but it is probably true because of the nature of the system.
You know why it's in Australia? Because Australia is federal.
So, gentlemen, we agree we have to go towards a federal system. Ano unahin natin? O isasabay-sabay natin? We force Congress to identify dynasty. We change the Constitution to reduce all the complexities of the writing and the coding system wherein for further review. Mm-hmm. or we just go straight into a federal study, go into a plebiscite, and ask all the multiple questions. Constitutional change, federal, parliamentary, will not the voter who will be made to decide during this plebiscite be confused? No, sa dami natin itatanong.
I think we just have to change the constitution, that's it. Because constitution contains everything of what system we'll have, who are we going to elect.
So maybe we shouldn't call it federal, we should just call it constitutional change.
Yes, we call it system change actually, system change.
We should change the topic here. From here on in, we will change it. Systems change.
Because federalism is just one of them. You have to change the entire electoral system. Because your electoral system now is tailored fit for those who have money.
Correct.
And for those who have the name.
Yes.
So you have to change that electoral system.
And lumaki, first federal and then parliament, then dynasty, system
Harry,
change.
My proposal will make you happy. Because I want to simplify the approach to this problem. I'd recommend to the president that he already at this particular point in time declares a revolutionary government. Because in a revolutionary government, the government is the law and the leader is the lawgiver. Okay. Now, constitution. Have that doggone thing be written by one single Filipino, submitted to the president. The president confers with authorities, maybe in 1 week's time or 2 weeks' time, to give them sufficient study. Yeah. And after the changes are made, okay, this is the draft constitution, which we will submit for the approval, to the approval of the people in a plebiscite. It can be done in 3 to 4 months. You know this debate in Congress? Mm. I've seen this before. Debates in Congress, in the Constitutional Commission, in the Constitutional Convention of Marcos. By God, they could not even agree on the fundamentals. So let's cut the Gordian knot here.
Do something like De Gaulle in France.
Yeah, Mr. President, that's it. This is the key. It will make Harry happy. It will make Ding happy. It will make me very happy. And a lot of people in this country.
I will no longer
really
need
happy
to do
for
this show.
Change.
If we have a system that works, there is no need for me to be in your face on TV. But then we have no more issues.
No, you are still needed, Harry, because...
No, but at least we can get rid of the joker.
Because you still need to laugh.
Yeah.
Even if we have already a federal system.
No, hang on, I'm not getting paid to entertain. Not to my knowledge. Or am I getting paid at all?
No. No, the ideal situation will never exist. We improve systems as we go along. That's why this program is necessary.
Yes.
Because even if a federal parliamentary system will be installed with a new constitution, there will still be discussions on the minutiae of the implementation.
So we agree on a revolutionary government. Is the President Duterte the right person? It seems you have the Liberal Party and all the different political parties that seem to disagree. Today's hearing in the Senate, I was surprised that the Senate press, the head of the Blue Ribbon, identifies that he comes from his own political party. He is not part of the LP or the PDP Laban. I mean, they are senators, and they're supposed to be working for the people of the Philippines, and then they identify their wherever they come from, like in America. Once you get president, you become president. Shouldn't you
president of everyone?
Shed the political party, like sinasabi ni Trump? Republican pa siya. Dapat wala nang party yan. Presidente ka niya.
That's established democracy. No? I agree with Trump entirely. During the electoral period, I was one of those who was cheering for him. Immediately context our present system, we really have to have systemic change. No? See, I've been always crying for systemic change. I am the one changing instead of the system. Because I don't have the power to do it. Now the president has the power to do it.
Is he the right president to do something this drastic?
Never mind of being the right president or not, just declare a revolutionary government.
I think what matters is, do we want to change the system or not?
That's the basic question.
I think that's the cry of everybody. Like all going around the country, this is exactly the cry that you hear.
Do we really want to change the system or not? Because if we want to change the system or not, then the next question is, when do we do it? Now, if we agree that we need to do it now, then we can agree on who is the best person to do it now, who is in a position to do it
only
now.
The president.
And you have the president saying that he's not only rocking the system, no, he is disturbing the system, he's rocking the system,
he is.
And he wants to change the system. So I'd agree that, okay, since we're on the track, then we might as well wipe out the entire system and have something in place.
You know, I would like to quote also the former editor-in-chief of the Collegian, Dito Sarmiento. And, during the stormy years, during martial law, he was saying this, kung hindi ngayon, kailan?
Kailan pa?
Kung hindi tayo, sino? You know, when the draft of the Constitution is presented to the president goes over it with the experts, no? With experts. And then he presents it to the people for ratification. The period, maybe not beyond 4 months, to explain the nitty-gritty mm-hmm. of the new Constitution being presented. And I'm sure the people will approve that constitution. Never mind the senators will demolish the politicians in the process because the new system will demolish them.
Gentlemen, we have come to the end of the show. Talking with you for an hour is just much too short. But then again, systems change cannot be done just like that, yeah. or can be done just like that. Before we go, what is your message to the viewers, Ding Generoso?
Well, very simply, we have a problem. And the problem is the system. Sistema natin, bulok. We've had the system for how many years? Over 100 years. Where has it brought us? The same problems, problema ni Narizal, ni Bonifacio, the same problems that we still have today. So maybe it's really time that we completely change the system.
Thank you, Ding.
My message is primarily for the president. Mr. President, declare a revolutionary government. Let somebody write the constitution, which you will review. And then after total review, have a definite period to explain the minutiae of the constitution. And the message to the people here is, give this guy a chance. Give Duterte a chance. You know, I opposed him during the campaign. As a matter of fact, I opposed many other things even after the campaign. But at this stage in time, you know, as Kennedy puts it, in politics, there are no permanent friends or permanent enemies. There are only permanent interests. And the permanent interest here is God, country, and people. We're Filipinos. And then when a good constitution is submitted to you for ratification, for heaven's sake, approve that constitution, and probably we will have a new day in this country.
Thank you very much. Very well said, Citizen Bono. Thank you very much. We hope you've enjoyed our show. I apologize we couldn't have Eric Sampang together with us here because we had some technical limitations, but hopefully very soon again we will have him with us to discuss these issues. Maybe the title and the topic is incorrect. It should not be more on federalism, but systemic change, system change. Maybe that's a better, bigger word for everybody else to understand. And till the next time, maraming salamat po. Watch us, that's 8 o'clock on Monday night. And 8 in the morning on Tuesday, the following day on replay. And if you want to look at it and look at the other shows, just go to YouTube, talk to Harry, one word, and you will see my face right in your face again. Maraming salamat po. Thank you very
Thank
much,
you.
Sir.
Thank you.
You are what you watch.